So you bought a camera. Figured you'd make some videos of yourself. And then you turn the camera on and you're like, wait, am I in focus? Oh, shit. Let me show you how to do it. So hopefully I'm actually in focus, because this would be a really stupid video. How to be in focus by the guy who doesn't know what the fuck he's doing. So I'm filming on the Panasonic G85 with the Miticon 25mm f0.95 lens. It's so shallow. That's why I got this lens. That's why I got this camera. Just because of this lens, I was like, holy shit. That is some shallow stuff. But as you can imagine, it's tough to focus, because if my eyes are in focus right now and I move, I'm out. I'm back. I'm out. And it gets hard, because I'm 5 feet away. I can barely see that screen. See that screen? I got another camera filming it. That's the Canon G7X. Hi. You don't care. Unless you have a Canon camera with dual pixel autofocus, don't even try it. There's only a few cameras that are capable of autofocusing, and even those, they get things wrong. You want your face in focus, and then all of a sudden it's like, oh, that wall looks nice in the background. What's on it? Oh, nothing. Paint. That's what's on it. So they get confused. If you're making a video like this where you're static, just put it in manual focus. I'll teach you how to do it. Let's get into the tips. Let me just get myself back in focus now. Look at that. Look at that. Okay. Here's what you want to do. If you're on the Panasonic G85, this will help with any camera, I believe. Just use what I'm saying and see if your camera can do this, and you'll get it. So for the Panasonic G85, you want to put focus peaking on low. For some reason, I thought high would be more pronounced, but you can barely see it, so put it on low. That's the first tip. Next tip is the profile. Usually I shoot in portrait. I haven't tested which one is best, but if you want to focus, go to custom. Look at how different the focus peaking is now. Look how much more pronounced it is. Portrait, you can kind of see it. Custom. So what I do, I raise the contrast, I raise the sharpness, keep noise reduction at nothing, saturation up a little bit, but play with it and see. You want to get this focus peaking really pronounced, because I could barely see it before I started tweaking this shit. Next thing, monochrome live view. Boom. Now you can tell. Now it's like super obvious. You want your eyes in focus all the time. So look how obvious that is. It's just like, all right, I nailed it. To take it one final fuck, to take it one step further, the magnification, you double tap the screen, now look where we're at. Look at this. That's how you do it from a distance. So if I want to back up, this is what you have to do. You kind of have to just back up and hope to dear Jesus that it works. So now I'm in position. That's good. I can tell. My eyes are all red, not because I'm high. How dare you assume that? So once you're done, you have all the settings you want to switch it back. So you take the monochrome off, and then you switch back to your normal profile, because you will look ugly as shit in that custom one with all the sharpness increased. So you got your portrait, now you're back, you're good to go. You know where you were, and see how hard it is to see now? I can barely see, but I remember where I was positionally, and this is the life of somebody who wants to shoot with a low aperture for that blurry background. I love that blurry background. You probably should just shoot at a wider aperture and just stop. Stop with the blurry background obsession, but I can't. It's like crack to me. F0.95 is crazy thin, so sometimes I gotta go up to 1.4, maybe 2.4 for the green screen stuff. 2.8 if you're a rookie bitch and you're just scared. You're scared of life. What kind of life is that to live? So this is how I do it. I hope that helps somebody. I'm realizing I'm filming this whole thing with just the Canon G7X. I'm an idiot. Let's face it. I'm that dumb. Forgot to turn the camera on. So, we're back. That's how you do it. If you have any questions, post them down below. I'd be happy to help. I'm like a camera freak now. Never used to care. But once I started making videos of myself, I wanted the best gear. And this is like the ultimate camera that I've ever had. I love this blurry background. Let me just show it to you. Everything is just so blurry. It's like it's not even there. You can't tell what's happening. What is that up there? That's a certificate. Could be for anything. I could be a doctor. I could be a lawyer. I could be neither of those. So I think we're done here. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you liked the video. Subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you in the next one. I couldn't tell if I was in focus at that last point. See how hard it is? That's why you gotta do all those tips in the beginning, and then don't move your damn arm. Ever.